singing in the spring air. They have everything they need. They don't worry where the next meal will come from. They don't worry about a thing. Seen the flowers in their colorful beauty. They're dressed better than a king. They don't worry about what they should wear, no. They don't worry about a thing. But look around you and try to listen to the song creation sing. And don't you worry, 'cause you're in the hands of the God who made everything. Now you know you're not a bird or a flower. You don't have petals or wings. But the good news is you're worth so much more to the God who made everything. So just look around you and try to listen to the song creation sing. And don't you worry, 'cause you're in the hands of the God who made everything. When you worry about today or tomorrow and the storms that they might bring, try to remember that you're in the hands of the God who made everything. Of the God who made everything.
Hey everybody, welcome to WOW! Nice. You did it excellently on the first try. That was awesome. We're going to open up together with the word of prayer. So will you pray with me? Hey, God, thank you for all the snow we got today. We know that it gives life to so many creatures. Be with all our siblings in Christ who are driving today. Keep them safe and keep them warm. God, gather us together to worship you tonight and to learn all about how you make things new. In your name we pray, amen. All right, I think we're all very excited to get into our big question box with Pastor Joy tonight, which is super exciting. So Pastor Joy, why don't you come up here? And Kieran, I think, is gonna come up and pick a question out of our big question box. So I need everyone to make a big drum roll. This might be going for a while. All right. Oh, great question.
Who wrote the Bible? Yeah. Who wrote the Bible?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know. What do you know, Pastor Joy?
Oh, I have to know?
Yeah.
I have to answer this?
I don't know.
Okay. So at my house, when we play games, you know, at Christmas and stuff like that, if we don't like the question we pick, we get to put it back in and take another one. Can I do that? No. Who wrote the Bible? Okay. Who wrote the Bible? So the Bible, Scripture, well, that's a very complex question because none of us were there at that time, right? And what we know about Scripture is that it's a collection of lots of different kinds of, oh, it's a fancy word. It's called genre. Different kinds of literature. It's some history, and it's some storytelling, and there's some mythology, like the creation story. And then there's lots of prophets that say things, and that was collected at one time. Then you get to the Christian Testament, the Hebrew Testament, and the Christian Testament. And there's Gospels, and the Gospels in the first century, there was never a form like that prior to the first Gospel, the Gospel of Mark. And then we have letters and all kinds of interesting books like Revelation and Psalms and things like that. So what we know is that this material was collected over a long period of time, going way back probably 2800 Now we say BCE, maybe further than that. And finally, it was all collected together in the second century by a council of the church who decided which books to collect together. And so that is how we have the Old Testament and the New Testament, the Hebrew and Christian testaments that we have today. How's that?
I don't know. What do y'all think? Did Pastor Joy do a great job?
Okay.
Oh my gosh, her first big question. Woo! Awesome. All right, thanks, Pastor Joy.
Sit down now.
You can sit down now.
Next time I'm going to take a different one.
Take it away, Jason.
Give it up for Jason and band. All right, well, there's a reason why we ask the pastors to answer those questions, because Pastor Joy did a great job, and a way better job than I would have done. So thank you, Pastor Joy. I am going to read to you tonight an excerpt, a story from that Bible book we were just talking about. And it may sound familiar if you were in worship this weekend, but it's going to sound a little bit different because in the Bible, or we have many translations of the Bible. And this translation is from the Message. So this is Matthew 2, 1 through 12. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem village, Judah territory, this was during Herod's kingship. A band of scholars arrived in Jerusalem from the east. They asked around, "Where can we find and pay homage to the newborn king of the Jews? We observed a star in the eastern sky that signaled his birth. were on a pilgrimage to worship him. When word of their inquiry got to Herod, he was terrified. And not Herod alone, but most of Jerusalem as well. Herod lost no time. He gathered all the high priests and religion scholars in the city together and asked, "Where is the Messiah supposed to be born?" They told him, "Bethlehem, Judah territory. The prophet Micah wrote it plainly. It's you, Bethlehem, in Judah's land, no longer bringing up the rear. From you will come the leader who will shepherd rule my people, my Israel." Herod then arranged a secret meeting with the scholars from the east. Pretending to be as devout as they were, he got them to tell him exactly where the birth announcement star appeared. Then he told them the prophecy about Bethlehem and said, "Go find this child. Leave no stone unturned. As soon as you find him, send word and I'll join you at once in your worship." Instructed by the king, they set off. Then the star appeared again, the same star they had seen in the eastern skies. It led them on until it hovered over the place of the child. They could hardly contain themselves. They were in the right place. They had arrived at the right time. They entered the house and saw the child in the arms of Mary, his mother. Overcome, they kneeled and worshiped him. Then they opened their luggage and presented gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. In a dream, they were warned not to report back to Herod. So they worked out another route, left the territory without being seen, and returned to their own country. And that is the word of the Lord. So we learned from the story. We hear a few things in the story. What are some things just shouted out that you heard? If you were listening. What were you handed, for those of you here in person, on your way in to worship? A star. So there's talk about a star. Okay. What else? A what? Oh, you were handed a pen. Oh, yes. You were also handed a pen. Thank you. I was like, there is no pen in the story. Yes. What else did you hear in the story? I cannot hear you all the way back there. You have a green star. Great. All right. So there was a king named Herod and some other people in the story, right? So it sounds like, from what I heard, that these magi, they followed this star, whether yours is green or purple or red, that signaled where they were going to find Jesus. So they listened to maybe what sounded a little crazy. I don't know. Like, hey, go follow the star. I mean, how many of you see a million stars in the sky? Yeah. So if someone told me to follow a star, I'd be like, which one? Yeah, so they took, I would say, a little bit of trust and faith to follow the star. And then they have King Herod, who's in the background saying some pretty not good things, right? Did you hear that? Just say yes. Yes, okay, great. So this is a pretty big story. So you probably are wondering why you have a star. And if you are not here in person and you're at home, grab a piece of paper and draw a star on it, and you can participate as well. So these magi saw this brilliant star in a faraway land that led them to the Christ child. And it really has me wondering, it really in all scripture, like, what does that mean for me? Because sometimes I read scripture and I'm like, cool, I don't know what that means for me. And I really want to know how it relates to my life. So I have an activity tonight because I don't want you to listen to me talk forever. You're going to pull out your star, and you're going to think, and you can either come up with this word tonight, or you can think about it. But I'd like you to intentionally think about a word that you this year, so we're celebrating the new year this year, or tonight, and first and foremost, I just want you to all hear that who and how and whoever you are and who God has created you to be is good and beautiful and perfect just the way you are, that there's nothing you need to change about yourself to love, for God to love you anymore. So we're not talking New Year's resolutions. We're just talking about what's one word that, and what is starting off to be another chaotic, crazy COVID time in this year. What is one word that you can center yourself around this year? You can center your prayers around this year. Just what's your star word? What might be that thing that you hear the Holy Spirit or God speaking in your ear, whispering in your ear? So you're going to write that one word on your star. So I'm going to reveal to you my word. My word is beloved. I love this word for many reasons that I can explain and many reasons I cannot explain. But I love this word because of who God has created me and all of us to be, beloved children of God, beloved people, beloved participants in God's ministry and God's world. There's so many ways that we can use this word, and I love it because it also calls me to view each and every single person I see in this space and in my family and my friends and in God's world and the community as God's beloved. And with that is a really big call, because it's a big call to me to interact with people in a way that honors them as being God's beloved. So that is why I chose this word. So you can write a word on your star, or you can wait. Or for those of you in small groups, you can take your stars to small groups, and if you want to share, that's great. If not, that's great too. And while you are finishing that, I have a prayer and a blessing for us. Long ago, Christians began celebrating the Magi arriving in Bethlehem, watching the sky and following stars, set their minds on heavenly things. The light held power that changed their course and opened their dreams to more beauty and justice than the earth had ever known. I wish to begin this new year by celebrating the possibilities beyond my own earthly will, to watch the sky and follow the stars, so that I remember that we are all made of heaven's own dreams. The flames are dancing and warm on this long winter night, a sign of what could be the way and guide toward purpose and love that threaten this world's callous comfort. We mark the thresholds of home with chalk like stardust to remind us where to look and how to travel with wonder. Amen.
Why don't we all stand up?
We are marching in the light of God. 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 We are marching, we are marching, oh, we are marching in the light of God. We are marching, we are marching, oh, we are marching in the light of God. We are dancing 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 in the light of God. We are dancing, we are dancing, oh, we are dancing in the light of God. We are dancing, we are dancing, oh, we are dancing in the light of God. We are singing 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 in the light of God. We are singing, we are singing, oh, we are singing in the light of God. We are singing, we are singing, oh, we are singing singing in the light of God. We are singing in the light of God.
I'm new here, can't you tell? Okay, hear the words of institution. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." We pray together in the words you taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. So we will be distributing down here, and you can come forward as you wish.
Thirsty, all who are weak, come to the fountain, dip your heart in the stream of life, let pain and sorrow be washed away in the waves of your mercy. Deep cries out to thee, come, Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come. All who are thirsty, all who are weak, come to the fountain, dip your heart in the stream of life, let pain and sorrow be washed away in the waves of your mercy. Deep cries out to thee, come, Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Cries out to thee, come, Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come.
All right, middle schoolers and high schoolers, stick around for like 2 seconds after the blessing, because Sarah's got an announcement to make, I think. Yes. Okay, awesome. We're going to do our blessing together. So I need everyone to put up a thumb in the air because we know that God is so, so good. And you can make a cross on your own forehead. And as we do that, let's say, child of God, you are loved. Ready? Child of God, you are loved. Amen.
Lost on a lonely road, I was chasing a highlight, trying to satisfy my soul. All the leaves I believed in left me crying like the rain. Then I saw lightning from heaven, and I've never been the same. I stand on the mountain, I'm gonna shout about it. I am a child of love. I found a world of freedom, I found a friend in Jesus. I am a child of love. Fire, saw you in the flame. Just when I thought it was over, you pulled me out again. I'm gonna climb a mountain, I'm gonna shout about. I'm gonna climb a mountain, I'm gonna shout about it. I am a child of love. Stand up. I found a world of freedom, I found a friend in Jesus. I am a child of love. I'm gonna climb a mountain, I'm gonna.